Hi guys, it's Jess. We are back with another episode of Let's Hear It for the Little Guys. Today we are at the Fragile Desert and we are going to meet up with some naked mole rats. Let's go. Chris Howes.
Hey Jess.
How's it going?
All right, how are you?
I see you gazing lovingly at the beautiful naked mole rats.
I love the naked mole rats.
Why do you love them so much?
So I write science and I learn about a lot of animals here. But we talk a lot about adaptations.
Yeah.
And a lot of times you can't see these right away and we have to explain them on signs to people.
Right.
But with naked mole rats, you can actually see these adaptations. They're adapted to live in these huge underground burrows. So,
yeah.
I mean, they're pretty unique that way. They have very small eyes. They can't really see that well.
Mm-hmm.
So they actually have whiskers to feel their way along in the tunnels and loose skin that helps them move around.
I love how they move backwards as fast as they move forwards.
That's true.
It's like they have eyes in the back, but they don't.
That's true. They're built to move backwards very quickly. They have the huge teeth that they use to dig tunnel systems about the size of a football field or more than one football field.
So, wow.
Yeah.
Well, I brought these, I brought a couple of tools
because
trying to understand how they use their teeth.
Right.
And I read somewhere that the top teeth can kind of move independently and then they just move along the tunnel.
Yeah.
But how do they keep from getting like dirt in their mouth?
Well, they have a flap that keeps the dirt from getting into their mouth when they tunnel. So if you're a tunneling animal, obviously you don't want to be eating dirt all the time. So
no, but they do eat poop.
They do eat poop.
Their own poop.
They do eat poop. They,
kind of gross.
Yeah. A little gross.
So why do they do that?
That's actually one way they can pass nutrients on to the young.
Yeah.
But they actually cover themselves in poop too. Their poop has a certain smell to differentiate them from other colonies of mole rats because they're all, you know, one colony will fight another colony if they ever came in contact, so they can smell how they're...
Like the jets and the sharks.
Exactly.
Well, I also heard you said colonies, and when you think of colonies, you think of like bees and ants.
Right.
And they're eusocial. They have their own sort of, I don't know, stratification in terms of the jobs that they do.
Right.
There's a queen.
Right.
Right.
There are workers. They're the ones who just dig. They're the ones who defend the colony.
Sure.
And then there's a queen who kind of rules over the...
queen.
Exactly.
Now, I heard she's not born into it. I heard this is some sort of like Sarah Connor thing. You have to overpower the other
whenever a queen dies, several of the biggest females fight for the right to be the next queen. So,
queen of the mountain
kind
of thing. And so how do humans fit in with naked mole rats? Is there a relationship between humans and naked mole rats?
Well, I would say no because naked mole rats are underground. So
okay.
I mean, unless humans go and sort of tear up their colonies and put homes and that sort of thing.
But, so they're well protected?
They're pretty well protected,
good.
They have two really, really amazing adaptations that researchers are looking at now. One is that they don't tend to get cancer. So
cool.
They're looking at that and how that applies to people. But then the other thing is they live a really long time. They can live up to 30 years or more.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah, absolutely.
30 years.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say they'd win any beauty contests, but...
I would say they would, actually. I think
really?
They're amazing. Yeah, I think they're beautiful and they're fun to look at just because they're so amazing. They're such,
all right, I can see that. So come here to the zoo and gaze lovingly
like
at
I do.
Them. Like you do.
Exactly.
Awesome. Thank you, Chris.
Absolutely.
Let's hear it for the little guys.
Woo.
Yeah, if you have any suggestions for little guys you want us to explore, go ahead and put it in the comments. We want to know what you want to know.